So the replacement frame has arrived. Not a shocker maybe, but it's an open up. It's a blue one and it's size large. It's basically exactly the same as my crash bike. With the crash replacement program that Open has, there wasn't really any question on what kind of frame it would be. So just if you didn't know, when you buy an open up frame, you can register it on the Open's website and you will get extended warranty and stuff like that. And you get the crash replacement policy program thingamajig, which is basically 50% off a new frame if you crash it. Terms do apply though, so yeah, check the fine print, yes, to be sure. So I won't do an unboxing on this one. I already did that the first time I built it up, so check that video if you want to, somewhere up here maybe. I haven't received all the parts yet, but the replacement lever for the right side is in the house. I also plan to try out two new parts that I didn't have before. The first one arrived today, and it's the new handlebars. This time I'm going with 3T's gravel bar, this model, however you pronounce it. The other new part hasn't arrived yet, and hopefully I have it by next weekend, so we'll probably do another video about that. This video though, we'll just do a quick look on this 3T handlebar. I couldn't really find any videos on this handlebar apart from the official marketing video, so I wanted to just visually compare this to my old bars and see what kind of difference we have. It's a pretty interesting gravel adventure bar, especially if you're like me, still kind of want to use it for proper road riding. So let's get into it. So this is the 3T SUPERGHIAIA, or however you pronounce this weird name. This is the smaller size. They come in two sizes, 44 and 40 centimeter wide at the hoods. But as you can see, the difference between the two sizes are a bit more than just the actual width. The bigger 44 centimeter one has a much more angled flare, while the 40 centimeter one has a more parallel flare profile. And as you can see, the drops on the 40 centimeter bars is 48. And on the 44 centimeter bars, there are a humongous 56 centimeters. I can definitely see the use for the 44 centimeters one for bike packing and really rough gravel, where you want to have a bit more stability. But for me, the majority of my riding is still on road, so 40 centimeters is much more to my liking. And just to confirm the real measurements, they seem to be pretty accurate. 40 at the hoods and 48 at the drops. So the weight, this was a really nice surprise. These 40 centimeter bars came in at 183 grams, which is quite a few grams lighter than the Easton bars. Yes, for comparison, the Easton bars, also size 40, came in at 217 grams. Feel free to correct me, but I think these 3T bars might just be the lightest gravel bars you can get right now. I can't remember if I've seen anything lighter for more gravel specific bars. Another nice thing about these, we have internal cable routing from the stem to the levers. So we'll see how neatly we can route everything once we get to start building up the bike. So once I compare this to my older Easton EC70AX handlebars, you can see another thing that's a bit different on the flare on these 3T bars. The flare actually starts below the actual lever. So once you mount the lever on these bars, the angle of the lever will be pretty much vertical, as you would expect on a normal road handlebar. Once you mount a lever on both of these bars, you can see the difference. With the Easton bar, with its 60 degree flare, has a much more outward angle on the lever. If this is a good or a bad thing, that's pretty personal, I think. But just from trying it on in my hands, I didn't have any trouble of reaching the lever or anything. Me personally, I think having the more vertical angle of the lever will be a bit more comfortable when you're up on the hoods. In the drops, I still can reach the lever no problem. One thing I really like is the tops is a bit more flat than the Easton bars. And that's kind of the only thing I missed on the Eastons, to be honest. The final verdict though will be made out on the road once I have this built up. So like you saw there, it's a pretty interesting bar, I have to say, and I'm happy I could save a few grams as well. Once I built this bike up, I will give a more in-depth opinion on how they actually feel, but just playing around with it now, I'm optimistic for sure. Hopefully that helped someone looking to get some new bars, might be an option. If you found that interesting or helpful, leave a like and subscribe if you feel like it. Always appreciated, and I will catch you in the next one. Peace.